welcome you here. Let me introduce myself. I'm Arevik, Saribekyan, director of the British Council Armenia office. Usually I like to address the Armenian audience in Armenian because I'm an Armenian myself, but taking into consideration the opportunity that this is an international seminar and we have guests from Europe, I would prefer to speak in English today, and you'll have translation if you need. I also want to introduce Anna Simonyan, who is the PR Marketing Director of Cafesjian Center of the Arts.
Indeed, I welcome everyone here at the Cafesjian Center for the Arts. It is very symbolic and it is very appropriate that this kind of an event, this kind of a project should be held at the Cafesjian Center for the Arts. Our center is a most unique cultural institution in Armenia. It was opened for public in 2009, and since then it has taken an important place in the cultural life of the country, primarily because of its role as a bridge, as a cultural bridge between Armenia and the rest of the world. We see our mission in presenting the best of the world's culture to Armenia and the best of Armenian culture to the world. And in this regard, the project that is being initiated right now is a very distinctive illustration of this mission. I realize that you have a very challenging task. It will probably be very challenging, very difficult, but also very important to enter into a fashion dialogue, to enter into a cultural dialogue. But I'm also positive that the Cafesjian Center for the Arts is the most appropriate and the most inspiring setting that you could have chosen for your project. Thank you very much, and I wish all the participants good luck, and I'm absolutely positive that the outcomes of the project will be valuable for all the cultures involved. Thank you.
I want to introduce our first presenter, Armine Kadegosyan, who is the president of the New Fashion Marketing LLC, and she's also representing the Armenian Fashion Council, that is the partner of the project, and the topic will be Armenian national costumes, symbols and characteristics.
I'm seeing here many familiar faces, many of my colleagues, also experts and teachers teaching at different universities. Happy to meet you here. My presentation will give you at least some idea of what Armenian costumes look like. Talking about Armenian history, we should start with the kingdom of Urartu and where the first evidences of Armenian costumes were found. It is after the 19th BC, and there was the huge influence of the Assyrian and Babylonian long gowns on Armenian costume. The statue that we're seeing, Arvani, the Armenian goddess of fertility, she's wearing a long Persian style gown and a long veil that is covering the head. And actually, Armenian cradle of civilization was the Urartu, and after that, when the Hittites, Phoenicians, and Assyrians, goddesses and princesses and the queens had their influences on shaping Armenian costume, we can also talk about the general style that was the worship of the goddess. And the worship and the symbols of the worship that Armenians had were very much like the animal body shape and human head symbols, carrying the head dresses that we will see later on very much interpreted into the costumes and kept till the 20th century. Also the veils that we're seeing on Arvani will be remaining till the 20th century as the main veil style of Akhaltsky region.
We're for enjoying it starting from this particular date, even mentioning the date. And the letters would be embroidered in the manuscript style art as you see on the right. But that's not obligatory that with all regions it would be in the red combination, the wedding costume.
Thank you. delighted to be here for this, the first formal event of this innovative and ambitious project. This sort of groundbreaking activity doesn't happen overnight. I'd like to commend and congratulate the British Council, their partner organisations in Armenia, and the other EU countries taking part, as well as the EU, for the tremendous hard work that they're putting into making this happen. The UK understands the importance of cultural relations, the web of contacts and connections that link them on the world. But our focus through the British Council is to promote real cross-border cooperation and intercultural dialogue. We'll celebrate the diverse cultural heritage of Armenia and the European countries taking part, as well as the cutting-edge design and technology. Thank you very much.
Journalist living in Berlin. I studied fashion design myself like about 10 years ago,
and decided to work in trend forecasting for 2 years later for an American company based in Chicago, and did some trend research and market and trend research. After coming back to Berlin, I corresponded for a magazine called Sportswear International. I brought it for you. Is this? It's a trade publication, so it's basically, it's not a consumer magazine, it's based on fashion trends and business trends. So this is what I'm doing since 6 years now. And I also consult for companies like the Danish Fashion Institute, the Mercedes-Benz Fashion Week, and other clients. And this is a designer called Michael Sontag. And he's around since 2 years now, I would say. And he comes together with a group of 3 to 4 other labels called Vladimir Karalev. And Majorta Plaskova. And we took those 4 labels because they studied in the same level, like in the same.
Lerna Inkarvitska, Horivera Zarta, Nachschwata, Guisero. Isk Evropakan, Hartavairain Evropakan, Shanjan Artik, Iranskot, Ankarun Naurish, I think Iran Ankarun, Busakan Ashkar, or best relief, Busakan Ashkar, or best ink composition. Եվ իրանց մոտ շատ ընդհանրացված բուսական դառնում ամբողջ կոմպոզիցիոն լուծումը։ Այդ իսկ պատճառով հետագա զարգացումը տերևնից է հետևաբար։ Մենք հիմա նայելով մեր ճարտարապետությանը, ընդգրկում ենք ճարտարապետությունը որպես 5 կոմպոզիցիոն կառույցի կոմպոզիցիոն լուծում։ Հայ դիզայներները անելու են եվրոպական հավաքածուներ, Եվրոպացի դիզայներները անելու են հայկական հավաքածուներ։ Միասին, միքսա լինելու։ Հա, սա արդեն ոճավորում, սա արդեն սարին։ Սա քանդակային աշխատանք է, որը կոչվում է նարե։